们祷告。
Let us pray.
主，今天早上愿你的灵来指教我们明白你的话。
Lord, this morning, may your Holy Spirit come and teach us so that we may understand your word.
也赐给我们有一颗谦卑的心来领受。
Give us a humble heart to receive your word.
我们祷告奉主耶稣基督的名。
We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. 你们猜我今天要讲什么？
Guess what am I talking about today? Holy Spirit.
讲圣灵啊，讲钱啊，我们还是要讲钱。
Yeah. We're going to talk about money again.
我们过去看了怎样放钱嘛。
So in the past few weeks, we saw how to allocate your money.
然后我们也看了怎样去看待钱。
And we also have seen how to, you know, see money.
这样接下来是要怎样？
So what's next?
怎样用钱啦？
You are right,
对啊，钱是要拿来用的嘛。
Yes, of course, money should be spent, right?
今天我们看的经文是非常熟悉的经文。
The scripture for today is something that we're all very familiar with.
一般上我们的理解都是这段的经文都是要我们管理好上帝给我们的恩赐。
Well, normally we'll take this parable as a teaching for us to be a good servant of God and in how to manage money.
而我们看这些恩赐。其实都是会看属灵的恩赐。
Talents here refer to our spiritual gifts.
然而我们知道金钱也是上帝给我们的恩赐。
Do you know that money is also a spiritual gift that God has given us?
加上主耶稣用钱财来做这个比喻。
Now, since our Lord actually talked about money in this parable,
所以我们今天就从金钱的角度来看这段的经文。
So let's look at the parable today from the perspective of money.
我们该如何做个金钱的好管家。
How do we be a good steward of money?
所以首先我们一定要知道我们只是钱财的什么主人还是管家。
First of all, we have to know this. Are we the owner or are we only the steward of money?
经文一开始讲到上帝把他的家业分给每一个仆人。
So we are only the steward. In the very beginning of the story, of the parable, here is a master. He gives out money to three different servants.
如果你仔细看经文，是按照他们的才干分给他们。
If you look at the Bible carefully, he actually says the master entrusts money according to the servant's talent.
所以一个给五千，一个给两千，一个给一千。
So the first one he gave 5,000, then the next one 2,000, then last one 1,000.
所以我们现在所拥有的其实都是上帝赐给我们的。
Which means whatever things that we have right now, they all come from God.
包括我们的钱财，我们的财产。
Including our money, including our properties.
所以还是那句，不管你的钱财是多还是少，
whether you have a lot of money or you do not have a lot of money,
都是上帝按照我们的能力赐给我们的。
The money is given by God according to our own ability.
如果我是一个卖云吞面的，
if I'm someone who sells, you know, wonton noodles,
我没有是讲在 Kopitiam 卖云吞面哈。
I'm not talking about those who are selling wonton noodles at Kopitiam.
我没有留想我的薪水一个月要200,000的嘛。
So it is impossible for me to keep on thinking that, oh, every month I must make out 2,000,000.
啊，除非你去印尼卖啦，有200,000印尼盾啊。
两百千 okay, so unless you do it in Indonesia.
所以今天你的能力多少？
20,000.
你所得的就是多少。
200,000, sorry. So you, whatever you get actually is on par with your ability.
都是上帝按照我们能够 handle 那个钱财的能力来给我们。
God gives you this amount of money because he knows that you are able to handle this amount.
今天很多人看钱看得很重了。
A lot of people nowadays, they take money so seriously.
包括基督徒在内。
Including Christians.
啊，钱财就好像我们的命根一样。
Wow, money is just like our life.
哇，一旦失去了。
Once I lose my money,
哇，好像要死这样。
Then I will die.
然后如果是那个钱跟其他人有关系的，
if that money has something to do with other people,
哇，我一定跟那个人死过。
Then I will definitely like fight till death with that person.
即使再好的朋友，
even the best friend,
再亲的亲戚，
like my closest relative,
都有情讲或者没情讲啊，没有情讲。
Definitely, we got nothing else to say but money.
因为对我们来说，钱是我辛辛苦苦赚来的。
Because you know those money, I made them so hard.
但是我们更要知道，
but we must know this.
如果 不是上帝给我有这个能力。
Had it not been God who gave me this ability to make money?
不是给我有这样的聪明智慧。
Had it not been God who gave me this wisdom?
不是给我有这样子的健康。
Had it not been God who gave me my health?
我们根本不可能拥有这些钱。
It would be impossible for me to earn those money at first.
Amen.
Amen.
所以因此一切都是上帝给我们的。
That's why all things come from God.
所以我们只是那个管家。
We are merely stewards.
什么是管家？
What does it mean to be a steward?
管家有支配权。
So a steward has an authority to assign, to allocate.
管家有使用权。
A steward has the authority to spend it.
但是管家没有拥有权。
And yet a steward doesn't have the ownership.
因为我们只是保管。
We are only there to keep.It's safe.
然后上帝给我们使用。
God gives it, God lets us, God allows us to spend it.
但是不代表这个全部都是我的。
And yet it doesn't mean that all these belong to me.
很多时候我们都知道哦，钱是上帝给的。
We know very often that God comes, money comes from God.
但是我们的实际行动常常都是越权了。
But our actual actions tells us the other way around. We are actually doing more.Beyond what we should do.
很多人都是紧紧抱着钱。
Many people, they're holding tightly to their money.
哇，死都不肯放手啊。
They'll never let go of the money.
但是我们要记得，我们一定要记得。
We have to remember this.
谁是你的老板？
Who's your boss?
上帝哈。
God is your boss.
不是钱是你的老板。
Money is not your boss.
你也不是钱的老板。
And you are not the boss of your money.
上帝才是老板。
God is the real boss.
我们是管家。
We are merely the stewards.
不是，我们不是这些财富的主人。
We are not the owner of all this wealth.
所以我们一定要认清这个东西，我们才懂得怎样好好的去运用我们的钱财。
Once we're clear with this, then we will be able to spend our money wisely.
而既然我们只是金钱的管家，
Since we're only a steward of money,
那总有一天上帝会要跟我们算账。
So sooner or later,God, the real boss, will come and we are held accountable before him.
可能我们基督徒很少去思考这个问题。
Maybe we don't really think about this often.
我们常常都会想，哦，如果上帝给我的恩赐，我没有好好用，上帝会跟我算账。
So we often think it this way. Oh, if I do not like use my spiritual gifts properly, then I will be held accountable before God.
哦，我们的生命没有好好活出来，上帝会跟我们算账。
If I do not live out my life properly, then I will be held accountable before God.
但是我们很少、很少、很少提过。我在用钱这方面乱乱用，上帝会不会跟我算账？
And yet very rarely we actually think about this. If I did not spend my money correctly or wisely, will I be held accountable before God?
因为使用钱财也是我们生活的一部分。
The way we spend money is also part of our lifestyle.
往往更是展现出我们本性的时刻。
And many a time the way you spend money shows your true character.
所以上帝也会跟我们算账，如果我们没有好好去运用的话。
Of course, we will also be held accountable before God in the way how we spend money.
马太福音二十五章这段的经文我们很熟悉。
Matthew chapter 25, we are all very familiar with this parable.
今天就不需要再仔细的跟大家解释了。
I will not like scrutinize at this Bible passage anymore.
经文就讲到那个拿五千的赚了五千，拿两千的赚两千。
So the Bible tells us that the one who got like five bags of gold, he actually made another five bags, and then the one with the two bags of gold, he made another two.
所以主人就说：“好，你这又良善又忠心的仆人，你在不多的事上忠心，我要把许多的事派你管理，你可以进来享受你主人的快乐。”
His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness."
那拿一千的有没有赚钱啊？
What about the one with only one bag of gold?
有吗？
Did he make any more?
没有赚钱哦。
No, he didn't.
这样有没有亏钱啊？
Well, did he lose any money?
我也没有亏钱哦。
Neither did he lose any money.
他就是原原本本的给回主人。
He just returned what the master gave him.
他说：“主啊，你是忍心的人啊。”
And then he said, "Oh, master, I knew you are not a very kind master."
那他刚好他那边没有地方收割，也没有散的地方要聚敛啊，所以他就害怕，他就把银子藏起来。
I know, master, you're someone who harvests on those places you haven't sown seed. That's why I was so afraid of you, and I went out to hide the gold underground.
主人有没有讲？哇，好啊，没有。至少没有亏钱啊，哈。
Did the master say, "Oh, well done. At least you didn't lose any money I gave you"?
主人说：“ 你这又饿又懒的仆人。
Instead, the master said, "Well, you wicked and lazy servant."
为什么主人会骂他又饿又懒的仆人呢
？So why did the master say, "You are so lazy and wicked"?
啊，等下我们来看哈。
So we're going to look at that later.
所以结果怎样？就把他那一千夺过来给那个一万的，因为五千赚五千，那个一万的。
So, the master took away the one bag of gold from that lazy servant and gave it to the first servant.
然后凡有的要加给他，叫他有余；没有的，连他所有的都要抢夺过来。
So for whoever has will be given more, and they will have an abundance. But whoever does not have, even what they have, will be taken from them.
那个拿一千块的仆人被上帝骂，被他主人骂，又饿又懒了。
The third servant was scolded by his master as someone who is wicked and lazy.
为什么饿
？Why wicked？
为什么懒
？Why lazy？
啊，懒就是他没有要想要怎样去。增值那个钱哦。
Of course, lazy because he didn't put in effort in how to multiply the value of the money.
他没有好好要去用它咯。
He hasn't been using the money given by the master wisely.
那恶就是他自己懒，还要找借口多多。
Wicked because he actually found excuses for his own laziness.
还要把责任推给他的主人哦。你主人，你就是这样的人嘛，所以我害怕嘛，所以我不敢用那个钱哦。
He even blamed everything on the master. Oh, master, you are such a wicked person. That's why I dare not. I was so afraid.
弟兄姐妹
，Dear brothers and sisters，
我们是怎样用我们的钱
？How do we spend our money？
我们有一直乱用我们的钱吗
？Do we always like squander our money？
还是你就是那些，你不管你赚多少钱，每次都是喊。没有钱用哦，没有钱用哦，不够钱用哦。
No matter how much money you make, you always say, "Ah, not enough money lah, not enough money lah."
我们是否因为乱用钱而导致上帝没有在金钱上祝福我们呢
？Well, have we been not using money wisely until God is not willing to bless us when it comes to money?
因为在这个比喻中，主耶稣有讲那个主人是有。惩罚那个一千的。
From the parable, we can see that the master in the story actually punishes the third servant.
因为如果你没有好好用，我就把你拿过来。
If you do not use what I've given you wisely, then I'll take away what I gave you.
像我们该怎样如何用钱呢
？So how do we spend our money?
通常有一笔钱在我们的手上。
Normally, when you get some money,
我们都会做两个举动啊。
You will do two things.
一个就是用钱哦。
You either spend it.
一个就是存钱哦
，or you either save it
啊。我们先来看用钱哈。
Let's take a look at how to spend money。
可能你讲谁不会用钱哦
？Maybe you will ask who doesn't know how
啊？谁不会用钱的
？Who doesn't know how to spend money？
每个人都会用钱呐、啊。
Everybody knows how to spend money。
我还要讲吗
？Do I need to keep on talking about this？
我们大概讲一下嘛。
Okay, let's go through it very briefly。
我们的钱。大多数都是用在哪里啊
？Where do we spend most of our money？
衣食住行。
On your clothes, on your daily necessities、
啊。因为那个是我们最重要、最基本的嘛。
Because those are the most important thing, most important component of our life。
然后很多时候，我们就在这些方面延伸出一些用钱不当的行为了。
And yet, it is from those areas we kind of like stand into some kind of unhealthy spending habit。
要怎样避免我们乱用钱呢
？How do prevent us from squandering money.
首先就是不要冲动消费。
First of all, say no to impulse purchasing.
跟隔壁的讲。
Let's say to one another.
不要冲动消费。
Do not purchase impulsively.
我知道买东西很爽的。
I know you feel so happy when you buy something.
而且是你有钱买东西的时候。
Especially when you have the money that you want.
你就很容易造成冲动了哦。
And then you will have this impulse purchasing.
你不要讲安弟安哥也是这样的。
You know, not even aunties,、啊、uncles are also like that.
特别是大减价的时候。
Especially during sales.
哇，五十八先呢，七十八先呢。
70% off.
哇，买三送五嘞。
哇 ，you buy three get five free.
哇，买。
Okay, let's buy.、
啊、买一大堆回家。
You buy a lot of things and bring them home.
结果到头来。
In the end.
那些很多东西都没有用了。
You don't really need all of them.
因为那些东西很多都不是我们需要的嘛。
Because we don't really need most of those things that we buy.
只是你觉得哇很便宜很歹我就买了。
You only buy them because you think that they are very cheap and you think, oh, it's such a great value to your money.
加上现在网购很方便啦。
And you know, besides now, it's so convenient to do online shopping.
更容易冲动哦。
It's even easier for you to impulse buying.
按罢了啊，按下去就买了。
Everything's just a few clicks away.
那还有一种情况呢。
There's another situation.
就是在买菜啊、买水果的时候，也是会冲动的。
You know, you even have impulse purchasing when you're buying vegetables and you know fruits.
啊，有时我也是那样。
Sometimes I'm also like that.
哇，看到很新鲜哦。
When I see, wow, it's so fresh.
哇，那个菜很美哦。
Wow, the veggie so looks so good.
就想哇，可以回家可以做什么？可以煮什么？
I should buy this and go back home and cook this and cook that.
结果买一大堆回家。
So I buy a lot of them home. In the end,
刚好又没有时间煮。
哎呀， I have no time to cook.
就算吃也吃来不及啊。
Even if I do have time to cook, I wouldn't be able to finish them on time.
然后就烂掉了。
So in the end, all those veggies get rotten.
然后很多都就浪费了。
And I actually waste my money on those things.
你是不是这样子啊？
Are you also like that?
箴言二十一章五节讲。
Proverbs 21 here it says.
殷勤筹划的，足智丰裕；行事急躁的。
The plans of the diligent lead to profit, as surely as haste leads to poverty.
所以千万不要冲动。
Do not impulse purchase.
你冲动，你就缺乏了。
Once you're impulsive, then it will lead you to poverty.
第二。
Secondly,
不要购买奢侈品。
Say no to luxuries.
你身上最贵的，你看一下多少
钱。Look at yourself. What is the most like expensive item that you're wearing right now?
啊，没有啦，少少罢了啦，四位数罢了嘛。
Only four figures.
没有啦，少少啦，五位数罢了嘛。
No, not a lot. It's not too expensive. Only five figures.
几十年前的人生活条件不是很好嘛。
Decades ago, people didn't have that kind of, you know, wealth.
啊，可能是我们的上一辈，或者可能。Uncle Auntie 小的时候
，So maybe in those were our parents' days, or maybe Uncle Auntie's when you were younger.
啊，大家都是为了要蹭那口饭吃而努力啊。
People worked very hard in order to make ends meet.
但这个时代不一样了。
But nowadays things are different.
虽然我们常常说经济不好，经济不好。
Even though we always say that economy is not good, economy is bad.
但是我们已经没有为三餐而烦恼了，对吧
？Yeah, we no longer worry about our next meal.
我们只是在想。烦恼什么？我要吃什么东西
？We only worry about huh, what to eat next.
啊，当然不只是吃什么东西。
Not only we worry about what to eat next.
很多更是为奢侈要买奢侈品而烦恼。
A lot of us actually worry about what luxuries to buy.
啊，那什么才是奢侈品呢
？What do we mean by luxuries?
很多人的定义都不一样啊。
Well, different people have different definition.
不过最简单的就是。
In a very simple way to put it.
它一定是高价格。和稀缺性的。
It definitely has this very high price point, and it is something that is scarce.
就是很贵很贵，而且是很少有的。
Which means it's super expensive, and you don't really see it everywhere.
那些 limited edition 的。
Those, yeah, 限量版的。
啊，像 Rolex 表这样。
For example, like Rolex watch.
家里有没有一只啊
？Do you have a Rolex at home?
里面是真黄金、真钻石的。
Wow, that Rolex watch, you know, it is actually made by real gold and real diamonds.
然后第二就是。有品牌价值的。
Secondly, it is something that carries a brand story.
简单来讲就是名牌咯。
Which means, you know, branded things.
LV 啊 ，Chanel 啊 ，Lamborghini 啊，还有很多，你自己去算一下。
Yeah, and all those brands that you know.
这些都是名牌奢侈品的牌。
These are like brands, luxurious brands.
第三。
Thirdly.
就是非必要性的。
Those things are non-essential.
就是手袋
which means like handbags,
珠宝
jewelry,
名表
and watches.
啊，环保袋也是袋
You know, recycled bag is also a bag.
几万块的 bag 也是袋
Even if you like 100,000 bag is also a bag.
啊 ，Proton Pro Duo 也是车
Proton Pro Duo is a car.
BMW Mercedes Benz 也是车嘛
BMW Mercedes they are also cars.
不同牌罢了。
But they are of different brands.、
啊、但是可能有人讲了，牧师你不懂的啦。
Maybe some will say, 哎呀 ，Pastor, you don't know 啊。
这些用料是真材实料来的吗
？You know this thing? They are made from very good, genuine material.
皮革跟环保袋哪里有的比哦
？This is genuine leather. How can you compare with a recycle bag?
对啦，我知道是真皮，是真黄金，是真手工。
I know it's genuine leather, genuine gold. I know it's craftsmanship.
那又怎样
？So what?
你要问你自己一个问题。
You have to ask yourself this question.
你真的需要它吗
？Do you really need it?
你看你的橱里面有多少个了
？Look at your closet. Already, how many you have earned?
我不是讲不可以买啦。
I'm not saying that you are not allowed to buy this.
如果你有这样的能力，你要慰劳自己，可以的。
Fine, if you have the ability and you want to like give yourself some kind of reward.
但是你不用买够十个在那边。
But you don't have to like buy 10 of them and put them there.
或者一天换一个的吗
？You don't have to like change every item every day.
这样子就非必要了。
Those are not necessary.
啊，如果你觉得还不能够说服你的话
，If I'm not like good enough to convince you now,
你再问你自己一个问题啦。
I want you to think one more question.
如果今天主耶稣跟你在旁边选 bag 的时候，你觉得
Jesus is actually standing next to you while you're choosing those bags.
主耶稣 ，Hermes 可以吗
？Hermes, Lord Jesus, is this good? Is this good?
你觉得他 OK 吗
？Do you think Jesus will actually say, "Oh yeah, sure, go ahead with it"?
啊，如果你觉得 OK 的话
，If you think it's OK，
那就 OK 了。
Okay, fine then.
如果你觉得主耶稣讲 No，
If you think that Jesus might actually say No，
啊，你就识走啦。
Then you know what to do.、啊、
所以不要购买奢侈品。
Say No to luxuries.
来，跟隔壁的讲。
Let's say to one another.
不要购买奢侈品。
Say No to luxuries.
第三。
Thirdly.
不要过度消费而欠卡债。
Do not overspend until you actually are in great card debt.
有人说，在商场上看着一个老公牵着他的老婆，哇，是一件很浪漫的事情。
People say, "Wow, it is so romantic to see a husband holding his wife's hands in the shopping mall."
事实上，是一件很经济的事情。
Actually, it is only something economic.
因为当老公一放手，老婆就去 shopping.
Because when the husband lets go of the hand, then the boy will keep on buying.
我们这个时代啊。
We live in this time.
债务跟过度消费是许多人面临的挑战。
Where debt and overspend is a great challenge to a lot of people.
因为许多人买，就是停不下手。
Because people are so addicted to buying, they just can't stop buying.
没有 break 了，你知道吗
？There's no break to this.
就算给他 break， 他也 break 不到。
Even if you ask him, please stop, then it's impossible for that person to stop.
啊，这时候银行就很好心了，就问你了。要不要 credit card?
And then the bank, out of kindness, will ask you, offer you, would you like some credit cards?
其实他们才是正牌的歹徒咯。
They are actually the legal loan shark.
就当你不当的使用啊，听好了呀，我不是讲不可以用啊，不当的使用 credit card 的时候。
When you spend money and using credit cards improperly,
结果就一发不可收拾了。
Things will like, let loose.
现在多少人是一张卡盖一张卡盖一张卡？
How many people nowadays actually issue one credit card in order to cover the debt of the previous card?
每一个月都是在还利息罢了。
Every month they're just paying the interest of their debit of their credit card.
你知道 Malaysia 有多少年轻人因为卡债而宣告破产？
Do you know in Malaysia how many young people are declared bankruptcy because of credit card debt?
所以求主帮助我们。
So may God help us.
要学习节制。
We have to learn to have.Self-control.
不要掉入物质主义的陷阱里面。
Do not fall into the trap of this materialistic.
因为你会变成消费主义的奴隶。
For you will become the slave of consumerism.
来，再跟隔壁的讲，不要过度消费，不要欠卡债。
Let's say to one another, do not overspend, do not get into card debt.
所以，如果你是用 debit card 是最好啦。
It's best if you are using debit card.
第四。
Fourthly.
要制定预算。
Set a budget.
因此，我们一定要制定预算。
We must set a budget.
你要知道你赚多少钱。
You must know how much you earn.
你要知道你的收入是多少。
You must know how much income you have.
你才懂得怎样开销。
Then only you know what should you spend on.
因为当你清楚你自己的财务状况。
Because when you are sure of your own financial status.
你就知道接下来这个月我有多少钱吃饭。
Then you will know, oh, in this coming month, how much money should I spend on my food?
我有多少钱买东西。
How much money I could go on buying things.
我有多少钱可以存起来。
How much money I can have to save up.
啊，那你就不会过度消费。
Then you will not overspend.
哎呀，买多了。
哎呀 I actually overbought something.
买贵了。
哎呀 it's a little bit expensive than my budget.
你就不会做一些超过你自己能力的贷款。
You will not, get any loan that is beyond your own ability.
贷款签下去是很容易的。
It is very easy. You just assign something to get a loan.
但是当你没有钱还的时候
，And yet when you fail to pay back your loan,
你给 bank 勒弄你就很惨了。
When you know the bank now has to ask you to get back your house.
如果你不够那个能力，你就每一个月头两一出的时候，你就开始烦了。
If you're inside this debt crisis, every early month you will.You are inside this worries of getting money and how to pay my debt.
所以每个月都在为钱烦，因为你不够，你已经 over 你的开销了。
Every month you're actually in the cycle of worrying about not enough money because you're in great debt.
所以再跟隔壁的讲，要制定预算。
One another set a budget.
如果你从来没有做过你的 budget 的话，
if you have never done,
快快做。
If never done a budget before, do it today.
你就知道你那些钱流去哪里了。
Then you will see clearly into which area your money go.
讲完用钱，要讲存钱。
Talking about spending money, now let's talk about how to save money.
赚钱是很容易的。
It is very easy to make money.
但是很多人却不会管钱。
And yet, a lot of people do not know how to manage their money.
所以很多人就是月光族咯。
A lot of people, they will have nothing left by the end of the month.
中秋节到了，月光光，你是月光族吗？
So mid-autumn is here, when we see this bright moon, are you also like that?
过去疫情爆发的时候，
In the past, during this COVID-19 pandemic,
有一个报道就讲，大部分的美国人银行存款里面都没有1000块美金。
According to a report that most of American young people they do not have at least $1,000 in their bank.
换来马来西亚
，In Malaysia,
你的银行存款有5000块吗
？Do you have at least $5,000 in your bank？
你不要讲中学生啦。
No, don't talk about the secondary students.
工作了的。
Talk about those who are working.
有5000块吗
？Do you have at least $5,000 in your bank？
其实我们马来西亚也是很惨的，你知道吗
？Actually, Malaysia, we are not any better.
早前不是很多人在那边朝政府讲要开那个 EPF 的第三 account 给他们拿钱的
？You know, just recently, a lot of people they want the government to open the third account of EPF so that they could withdraw money from that account.
为什么
？Why？
没有钱嘛，没有存钱嘛。
Because they don't have any savings.
所以可以见得赚钱重要，理财更重要。
So even though it's important to make money, it is even more important to manage your money.
好不好？我们一起来读箴言书21:20。
Shall we now read this out together?
来中文的先哈，来一二三，
智
慧
人
家
中
积蓄
宝
物
膏油，
愚
昧
人
谁
得
来
谁
吞
下
？Let's read it out in English.The wise store up choice food and olive oil, but fools gulp theirs down.
谁得来谁吞下，就是赚多少用多少。
So here it means that you just spend everything that you get.
当然，如果你今天是有钱存的
，Of course, if you have money to save,
就表示其实你是会用钱的
，which means you are good at managing your money,
并且是有规划的
，and you have this wonderful plan.
不过存钱也是要有智慧的
，you also need wisdom to save up your money.
不是随随便便就把钱存在银行啊
，you can't just put all the money inside the bank.
放在保险箱啊
，or just put inside your safe.
放在米乐拱啊
，put inside milk can.
因为现今世界的这个经济都一直在浮动嘛。
We know that, you know, currency is really not stable nowadays.
如果我们没有智慧去存钱的话
，If we do not have wisdom in saving money,
你的钱会越来越少的。
Your money will actually dwindle in value.
不是讲你的钱会被人家偷走。
I'm not saying that people will steal your money.
因为你的钱的价值会越来越小。
I'm just saying that the value of money decreases all the time.
我们都知道马币都在贬值的嘛。
We know Malaysian ringgit is so good at that, right?
不过最近上回来一点点了啦。
Thank God, like recently it has gone up slightly.
不过还是新币比较香嘛，是吗
？But of course, Singapore dollar is way much better.
还是很多人想要去新加坡赚新币。
A lot of people still want to go to Singapore to make money there.
你想一下哈。
Let's think about this.
40年前哈。
40 years ago.
那些40年前还没有出师的你就不懂了。
Those who weren't born yet is fine.
40年前10万块大吗
？40 years ago is like a 100,000 ringgit.Big? Was it big? 100,000?
可以买到 condo 吗
Could you buy a condominium at
that
time?
可以哦
Yes, right.
40年前可以
40 years ago.
100,000可以买 condo.
10,000, you, 100,000, you were able to buy a condo, 100,000.
如果你把那个100,000存起来放在保险箱里面。
If you were to save up that 100,000, put them inside safe.
现在拿出来用。
Now you take it out and use it.
你买到 condo 吗？
Can you buy a condo now?
不要讲买 condo， 装修费都不够。
It's not even enough for your renovation.
所以你要有智慧的存钱。
That's why we must have wisdom even in saving money.
啊，可能有人说没有啦，我没有傻傻这样放啦，我有放定期存款的嘛。
Say, no, I don't just put it inside the bank. I actually put it in FD.
虽然不是很高啦，那个利息。
Even though the interest is not that high.
但相对比较安全嘛。
But it's actually safe relatively.
啊，或者可能有些人讲哦，我可以去放一些基金啊。
Some say I actually put money in some funds.
或者有些人更聪明，直接放公积金。
Some even like a smarter.
No EPF.
Some just put inside EPF.
啊，公积金利息很高一下的嘛。
Because it has a higher interest, right?
也相对也是安全啦。
And it's also very safe.
如果公积金的钱没有了，就表示这个国家也是破产了。
If EPF has no more money, which means the country is in bankruptcy.
所以只要我们的钱要存放在一些能够。让它增值的地方，而且是相对安全的。
As long as you put money in a place where the value will increase and it's rather safe,
这样还是有一点智慧去存钱。
Then you have this wisdom.
因为只要我们的钱哈，因为为什么我讲相对安全呢
？Why do I say relatively safe?
只要我们的钱放在地上，就一定有风险了，对吗
？As long as you put money on earth, definitely there will be some risk to it, right?
你放在 bank, bank 会 bankrupt 的吗
You put it inside bank, the bank might go bankrupt.
你放在你的家会给人家偷的吗
You put it at home, you will have burglary.
上次已经讲过了。
We talked about this last time.
所以一定有风险，只是那个风险是高还是低。
There must be certain risk, either it's a high risk or low risk.
所以如果你今天要存钱，不管你存在哪里，
If you want to
save money,
最主
要的就是要低风险。
Most important of all is you have to make sure that it is low risk.
在主耶稣的教导中
Now, according to the teaching of our Lord Jesus,
他也教导那个一千的要怎样去存钱。
He actually taught the third servant how to save the money.
是吗？你放在地上
，You bury underground，
没有用的吗？好过你拿去放存起来有利息的去赚那个利息。
It's useless. Why didn't you actually put it in the bank so that it get at least some interest?
可能你会说，哎，这个时代没有人放 bank 了的啦。
Maybe you say nowadays no one saves their money in bank anymore, Pastor.
定期存款才多少？多少八仙？
两
到三八仙罢了嘞。
Only 2-3%.
倒不如我们拿钱去投资咯。
Why don't we invest our money instead?
啊，你有没有投资啊
？Have you been invested in anything? Have you been investing in anything?
投资有几种啊？有些人 有些人投资股票。
Some that invest in stock market.
有些人投资房地产。
Some that invest in properties.
啊，现在比较兴的投资加密货币。
So nowadays, the most popular one is this encrypted coins, currency.
可以投资吗
Can we, Christians, do investment?
可以玩股票吗
Are we allowed to play with stock market?
可以炒楼吗
Can we, like, you know, also be part of properties?
那我们就要弄清楚什么是投资了
We have to be very sure, very clear with what does it mean to invest?
投资其实真的是一种理财的方法
Indeed, investment is one of the ways to manage your money.
投资必须是长有长远的计划的。
You must have a long-term planning for this.
比如说，如果你是为了你将来孩子的这个学费
，For example, you're actually planning for your children's future education fee.
啊，你去做那个投资。
That's why you do that investment.
你是为了将来自己养老金。
You're making that investment for your own, you know, retirement.
啊，你去投资。
Yeah, you make that investment.
因此，这些真正投资的人，他不会看那些很短的这些股价、楼价这些，他不会看的。
These kind of investors, they do not care about the short-term, you know, value of the stock market or the property market.
因为他都是放长远来看，五年、十年、二十年。
Instead, they're actually looking at like beyond 5 years, 10 years, 20 years.
就算最后亏钱了
，Even if in the end they lose your money.
他都是有能力去承担的。
They are able to cover up their loss.
而不是像现在很多人 all in.
Unlike a lot of young people nowadays, they actually put all in.
哇，把整副身家丢进去搏。
They really put in all they have.
因为现今这样子做的人，他不是在投资，他是在投机。
Those who are doing this, they are not investing. They are actually speculating.
就是希望在短时间里面得到一个很高的酬报。
They want to make the biggest money in the shortest time.
啊，不管是股票、货币、地产。
No matter what they play.
就是希望在短短的时间我能够套利。
They want to like get the best profit they could in the shortest time.
这些是投机，不是投资。
This is speculation, not investment.
啊，比较容易掉入这样子的陷阱的，通常都是买股票或者加密货币的人。
Normally, those who will fall into such a trap are those who buy buy stock market and also those who buy this and cryptocurrency.
如果你有买这些东西，你就知道什么叫开杠杆，对吗？
If you have done this before, of course you understand what does it mean to, you know, to do this leverage.
就是希望用小小的钱能够赢拨到大大的利润。
Which means you want to use the least money to make the most money.
但是它的风险是很高的哦。
And yet, this one has a very high risk.
所以很多人搞到爆仓就是这样了。
That's why a lot of people they actually like lose a lot of money in the end.
就亏完所有的钱。
They lose everything they have.
看到可能有些看到要爆仓了，哇，快点去补仓咯。
Maybe some when they see that they're about to lose money, they quickly put in more money.
钱从哪里来？
Where do they get the money from?
你都 all in 了哦。
Since you already put all in.
跟别人借钱哦、
oh, they will start borrowing money from others.
结果就欠很多人
In the end, they are in great debt to a lot of people.
所以我们很多很多这样子的人都掉入了这样子的陷阱里
面。Many people fall into such a trap nowadays.
然后再不然就是信错人
or,
看错东西
Maybe they have, you know, they have trusted the wrong person. They have actually looked at things wrongly.
所以我们在报纸上也可以看到很多人被骗。
That's why we can see a lot of news nowadays that people get cheated.
因为投机的行为就跟赌博一样。
Because when you do speculation, it's no difference from gambling.
因为你背后的动机就是希望在最短的时间我能够赚到多多的钱。
Because the motive behind is to make the biggest money in the shortest time.
那个就是贪恋。
That is actually greediness.
那个不是存钱
That is not saving money.
那个只是希望、哦、我快快能够财务自由我不用做了就有被动收入
That is actually thinking about how I could like, you know, get my financial freedom as soon as possible and then I don't have to work anymore.
所以我们要很小心
We have to be aware of this.
我们今天基督徒我们是投资还是投机呢
So Christians, are we investing or are we speculating?
所以每次当你要做这个投资的时候，你觉得是投资的时候
，When you think that you are investing in something，
还是建议你
，I would like to suggest you，
你祷告主啊，这个投资 OK 吗
？Why don't you pray first and ask God, Lord, is it okay to invest in this？
我相信只要我们是顺着圣灵行事
，I'm sure as long as you follow the guidance of the Holy Spirit，
你是顺从圣灵的带领的话
，as long as you actually follow。The Holy Spirit.
你肯定有属灵的洞察力。
You will definitely have this observation of coming from the Holy Spirit.
你会知道这个东西是不是有危险的。
You will know whether this thing is risky or not.
你会知道这个东西是不是应该去投资的。
You will know whether you should do it or not.
如果你的内心是很怀疑、很没有平安的，你就知道圣灵让你知道这个东西，你不要去碰它。
If you're full of doubt and you're not sure about this, then It is actually a sign coming from the Holy Spirit telling you not to do it.
因为诗篇二十五篇十二十三节告诉我们
Because in Psalm here it says,
谁敬畏耶和华，耶和华必指示他当选择的道路，他必安然居住，他的后裔必承受地土。
Who then are those who fear the Lord? He will instruct them in the ways they should choose. They will spend their days in prosperity, and their descendants will inherit the land.
没有放到这个经文哈。弟兄姐妹
so dear brothers and sisters,
如果我们今天是赚很多钱的
if you make a lot of money nowadays,
如果却不好好的用钱
and yet you do not spend your money wisely,
你觉得你是在赚还是在赔
do you think you're actually making money or you are losing them?
你好好想一下
think about it carefully.
所以当我们管理钱财的时候
when we are managing our money,
我们要不断的警惕自己
we have to warn ourselves all the time.
千万不要掉入在贪财里面。
Do not fall into this trap of greediness.
我是一直在抓住钱。
Am I keep on holding to money?
还是被钱抓住？
Or am I being held by money?
到底我是金钱的管家？
Am I the steward of money?
还是被钱控制的奴隶？
Or am I a slave to money?
上帝造我们每一个人都是管家。
God has made all of us stewards.
如果你看创世纪
If you look at the Genesis,
你就知道我们有责任要管理这个世界。
You'll know we have the responsibility to take good care of this world.
但是在谈管理世界之前，我们有没有先管理好自己的东西？
Before we talk about, you know, governing the whole world, have we been able to govern ourselves,
特别是我们的金钱，
especially our money.
盼望我们都学习做一个金钱的好管家。
I really hope that all of us will become a good steward of money.
因为如果连一点点钱都管不好的话，
if we fail to take good care of little money that God has given us,
如果今天上帝给你三千块，
if God gives you 3,000 today,
你都管不好，
you can't manage it well.
你觉得他会给你十千块吗？
Do you think that God will give you 10,000?
你做老板你会给吗？
If you are the boss, will you do that to your employees?
肯定不会给。
Definitely no.
所以这个是很正常，
so this is something
很
very normal,
逻辑的事情。
Something very logical.
所以因为真正的财务自由，
Because the true, genuine financial freedom.
今天我们常常都听人说，哇，财务自由。
You know, you hear these terms a lot nowadays.
真正的财务自由不是你不用做工就有许多的被动收入。
You know, the true financial freedom doesn't refer to you do not have to work and you have a lot of passive incomes.
真正的财务自由是你不会被金钱捆绑。
Financial freedom means truly that you are not being bound, you are not being chained by money.
而且你是有智慧的去使用金钱。
And you have wisdom to spend your money.
把上帝托付你的。
You're able to govern properly all the money and properties that God has entrusted to you.
所以你是不会在意有钱没钱，多钱少钱。
You do not really care about do I have money or not, do I have a lot of money or not.
不管多钱少钱，你都会充满感恩。
A lot money or not, you will be filled with gratitude.
你都会知足。
You will be filled with satisfaction.
你依然会很爱主。
You continue to love God.
依然热心。侍奉,
you continue to serve him with passion.
乐意奉献,
you continue to offer willingly and cheerfully.
但是很可悲, 现今许多, 我可以讲许多基督徒, 因为钱啊,
and yet,
慢慢冷淡了。
I have to say very pathetically, a lot of Christians, they actually turn cold because of money.
严重的, 慢慢离开主。
And the more serious one, they actually leave God gradually.
所以要真正的财务自由。
If you want to enjoy true financial freedom,
不要被钱捆绑。
Do not be chained by money.
你就自由了。
Then you are free.
Amen.
Amen.
最后我们用这段的经文来彼此勉励。
Finally, let's encourage one another using this passage from the Bible.
路加福音十六章十节至十三节，我们请中文的来念，然后到英文的来念。我们慢慢的念 ，OK？ 你就慢慢的去想主耶稣讲什么东西。来，一二三。人在最小的事上忠心，在大事上也忠心，在小的事上不义，在大事上也不义。倘若你们在不义的钱财上不忠心，谁还把那真实的钱财托付你们呢？倘若你们在别人的东西上不忠心，谁还把你自己的东西给你们呢？一个仆人不能侍奉两个主，不是恶这个爱那个，就是重这个轻那个，你们不能又侍奉神又侍奉马门。来，英文的。
Whoever can be trusted with very little can also be trusted with much, and whoever is dishonest with very little will also be dishonest with much. So if you have not been trustworthy in handling worldly wealth, who will trust you with true riches?And if you have not been trustworthy with someone else's property, who will give you property of your own? No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money.
所以最后跟你隔壁的说，
Finally, let's say to one another,
要好好管你的钱。
Manage your money wisely.
还有，
And?
要好好用你的钱。
Spend your money wisely.
最后
Finally,
要好好存你的钱。
Save your money wisely.
我们同心祷告。
Let's pray in one heart.
主，我们感谢你。
Lord, we thank you.
感谢你给我们钱财。
Thank you that you have given us riches.
好让我们在生活上能够得到我们所需要的。
So that we have no lacking in our daily life.
主啊，求你真的是常常警惕我们。
Lord,Remind us all the time.
保守我们的心思意念。
Guard our heart, guard our mind.
因为我们是最常最容易被金钱而捆绑的。
For we are tempted by money easily and most oftenly.
而且也许多人掉入金钱的陷阱里面。
Many people have fallen into the trap of money.
原本很爱你的。
Those who once loved you so much.
都慢慢远离你。
are now gradually staying away from you.
主啊，求你赐给我们有敬畏的心。
God, give us a heart that fear you.
好，让我们有智慧如何去管理我们的钱财。
So that we have the wisdom on how to spend and manage our money.
让我们做个忠心的好管家。
Help us be a faithful steward.
而不是变成金钱的奴隶。
And not a slave to money.
愿你赐福我们所有弟兄姐妹。
May you bless all brothers and sisters.
让我们在金钱上能够荣耀你的名。
Help us to glorify your name when it comes to money.
我们这样子祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名。
We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.